This is the VNA from the company R&S Rodin Swartz, model JVH8. So as the model is suggesting, it can go up to 8 gigahertz of frequency, starting from almost 900 megahertz. And this one is the calibration kit, combined calibration kit. If you have a little bit focus over here, you can able to read the various calibration component. So this one is the short open. This is representing the through connection, and that one is the match load. I should rotate in this direction. So this is now readable. Open, short, through, and matched connection. So 1, 2, and 3 are the one port calibration center. Whereas through is making the a line connection for through, or you can say the transmission measurements. For the demonstration of measurement, we have selected few components. The first component is the fixed attenuator, and it is made from the HP company, and it is a model number 8491B, and as you can see, it is written 10 dB. So this is a fixed attenuator which can able to provide attenuation of 10 dB. Since this is a type N connector, type N male connector, and this is female connector, type N female connector, this attenuator can easily work up to 18 GHz starting from DC frequency. The second component is the antenna, special antenna, and this is designed on the basis of 2x2 array. So two antenna is on the two row, one two row, and other antenna is on the two column. So this is making 2x2 array, and a common feed is given to all four antennas simultaneously using the type N female connector. The fourth component we have made to work as a two port component. So this is the actual attenuator, and this port is a waveguide port. This port is a waveguide port. We have added another component that is known as a waveguide to coaxial adapter, one side, and this is on the other side. Since two different companies adapter we are using, so that's why we are having the two colors. Okay, that's but the component name is same, and this emission will be up to 8.2 to 12.4 gigahertz. So I doubt that we will be able to measure something with this attenuator in existing VNA, since VNA can go up to 8 gigahertz. So the similar attenuation you have seen on the waveguide test bench. So we are going to see the demonstration of the calibration of this VNA and the scattering parameter measurement of this component using this existing VNA of model JVH8. So this is the VNA. You can see here this is the model written JVH8, and although it can also be used for the cable and antenna characterization, as it is mentioned, the minimum frequency it is having starting from the 100 kHz to 8 GHz. So this is nothing new thing. You can get the model of any instrument which you are going to measure, what is the frequency range, especially for all microwave measurement instrument like the SNA, VNA, or the spectrum analyzer. And this is the one of the company which is making this kind of instrument. With the biggest area is covered on the front panel of any system or any microwave measurement system is the display. And this is not a touch screen display, but it is similar like a CRT display. And we are having various functions. We can see here these functions can be selected either by pressing the F1, F2, F3. And by pressing F1, F2, F3 or F6, we are selecting these functions on this VNA. So like if I select this F1, it is going to select which calibration you would like to use for the calibration of this VNA. So that we will do later on. First, let's focus on whether there are some keys on this VNA. This is the keypad, number keypad or the numeric keypad. We can able to enter any number for selecting of the frequency range or selecting the axis in horizontal direction as well as in the vertical direction. So as this is a VNA working in a frequency domain method or frequency domain measurement, so it on the y-axis, in the y-axis we are having the amplitude, normally the ratios, so we can able to directly obtain the scattering parameter versus frequency shown on the horizontal axis. So these are the number we can able to specify some certain range for selecting the frequency start to the stop or any other parameter. So you can see here also gigahertz minus dbm, megahertz dbm. So although those parameters looks to be same like minus dBm and dBm, but typically we use the minus dBm to show the negative values of scattering parameter. But if this VNA is characterizing the amplifier, that will give you the high value of a gain. In that case, we can measure the dBm value from this VNA, as well as there are some other range, kilohertz or the hertz, for inserting the manual frequency value. There are simple back, cancel, or the enter keys, which are readily available on the keypad of any computer. And in addition to that, if you want to start the cal process, press this cal. If you want to change the bandwidth or you wanted to SIP in certain frequency range, you must use this for getting the trace. So in trace means which kind of a trace you want, kind of a scattering parameter S11, S22, or whether you want to change the format from the for a complex scattering parameter from the rectangular to the polar plot or any other format. Similarly, we can able to have some lines on this, and mode, measure, marker, and if you want to change the position of marker, go for this. So I'm going to use one by one key. There are some further scales for distribution of frequency, formatting, which format you want, or the span period, scale for the amplitude shown on the y-axis, and I just forget what is this wizard. Want to have the presetting of this device, just press the preset button. So these are the normal keys available in maximum microwave instruments, including the SNA, VNA, and the spectrum analyzer. So now see here the values are written, and this is 1 dB minus 9 dB. So in between we will have the 0 dB, which is normally our reference label. And this, when you switch on the any VNA, it will show depending on the trace, like S11 cal magnitude. We can able to change the value of trace by selecting the trace button, which kind of a stress you wanted to have. So this will show you the S11 and S21 in the same time or in a common display. If you want to change any other mode, there is a possibility to change the averaging or suppression on and off of the signal. So this only the representation which is easily able to see on the system. So like it is representing the trace 1 and 2. So 1 is for the S11, the 2 is for the S22. We can move from 1 to 2 also. Okay, 1 to 2 also. And then there is a possibility that whether you want to store this data into the memory of this VNA, or you want to take the data from the memory to the trace. So every possibility is there, and this is the feature of nowadays every modern instruments. This is an important cursor which is able to change the position of the marker. Like I am selecting the marker at 1.34 GHz frequency, I can change this value by changing this manual knob, and at the same time it is giving you the frequency and the corresponding S11 value. Okay, so you can see this is the use of this marker. You can able to find any value of S11 at the desired frequency. And if you go to find out the F1, that will give you the marker position, marker type. Now the marker will have the two kind. One is the direct marker value, that will give you the value of the amplitude or the ratio at certain frequency, or otherwise you can select the delta marker. So it is taking the marker 1 as a M1, and delta marker is representing the difference of the two signals. So delta marker 2 is 91.22 dB. So this is the difference of the two signal. One signal is here, you can see the two lines, one line is here and one line is at the bottom. So the difference of these two signal are shown here as difference of as a D2 or the delta marker minus 95.30 dB. So what this is giving us the information that at 2.24 GHz frequency, we are having the S11 is equal to minus 1.48 dB. And it is an ungraded data. So the value will keep changing continuously. And in this scenario, we are having the value of S21, which is corresponding to about 89 dB. So the difference of this will be giving this much of a value. So depending on the requirement, we can go. Now coming to this cal, I press the cal, there is options available to calibrate the VNA for the full two port with high accuracy, full one port. Any other cal, we can select this cal option by pressing this one. So if you want to normalize the transmission or transmission with the high isolation, this normally we do not use. And there is possibility to do the cal setting, that means which is a non-zero length. In that case, you can manually enter the value of the non-zero through line. Like I wanted to enter, I guess I'm not able to do that. Yeah. So this is zero, and if I would like to enter 9 mm. So this is given the 9 mm, so I can initially insert the length of the non-zero through connection in offset port 1, or if there is a change in the pole. And since this is the software based, this is already given by the manufacturer that all details of this calibration kit, which is made by the Rohde & Schwarz company, is included inside this network analyzer. So that kit will be recalled. And what kit we are having the calibration kit of model JV Z170, and these connectors are the female connectors. So this is the female JV Z170 calibration kit which is available with us. This network analyzer can use all these calibration kit, but again the calibration kit will be purchased separately, and that includes normally cost about 1 to 1.5 lakh for each calibration kit. Now coming to the calibration of this VNA, so first this press the cal, and you have to select whether you want to the full two port calibration or full one port calibration. Since we are using the two port devices, we will be more focusing on the calibration of the full two port. After doing the full two port calibration, we can perform the scattering parameter of any DUT, whether it is a two port DUT or the one port DUT. So I am selecting this full two port. On selecting this two port, it is first asking which calibration kit you wanted to use for calibration of this VNA. So already we are having the JV, this model JV Z170 female calibration kit, and so I will continue simple because I'm going to use this one. And now it is asking, starting the calibration step. The first step in this is calibrate open. So I will connect the open standard to port number 1 as per the instructions given in the on for this VNA. So this kind of instructions is available with every VNA which are available nowadays. So port 1, so port 1 is this cable and port 2 is this cable. So it is asking to me to connect on open to the port number 1. So open is here. So open is here, I'm just connecting. Remember, this is a type N male connector, so they are not sexless connector. I have to connect like this. So the idea is that, or the important factor is that, you must go very slowly while connecting any two connector. Using at micro frequencies. So this open is connected, you can see. And now it is mentioned here, press continue to start the calibration. So since I already connected the open standard to port number 1, I press the continue, and it stores now the data of the open into the memory of this VNA as the one port calibration we had discussed in our theory class. Now it is asking me to connect the open standard to port number 2. So I will connect this open standard of this calibration kit into port number 2. Okay, so after pressing this key, as a second step, it is asking me to connect the open standard to port number 2. And as it is asking me to connect the open standard to port number 2, the test has automatically changed from S11 to S22. And you can see it is checking whether you are connecting the open standard magnitude or not. So I already connected the open to port number 2, and this is giving me the value of S22 near about 0 range. So since I already connected the port number 2 with open standard, I will press this key, and now it will calibrate. And once the calibration is done, you can see the value has been changed. Now coming to the next step is calibrate short. For calibration, please connect a short to port number 1. So you must recall, when I am adding these standards are giving me the error coefficient, which will be used at a time when a DUT will be connected into the port of VNA. Now short is connected, continue.
So this time the shot was connected in port number 1.
Shot
is connected to port 2 of this VNA, and once pressing this again, it is asking me to connect load to port number 1. And as you are seeing that a connection has been made between the match load and the termination, without pressing the continue or without pressing the calibration, the value of S11 has been reduced less than minus 29 dB. Now once pressing the continue, the value should be almost showing me the negative value. Okay, this calibration is done. Now please connect load to port number 2. So load is connected to port number 2 and I've pressed. So since I'm performing the full two port calibration, the fourth standard for the two port calibration is the through connection. So three connected two connection is simple. For calibration, please replace the duty by a through connection. Connection is made, you have seen, and after connecting the through connection, press continue, and that will make some tracing of the S11 as well as the S21. Okay, both are the S11, so I need to change this traces. So after completing the cal, if I press the measure key, it will represent the S11 in trace 1, S21 again in trace 1, you can see here S21, F3, S12 and F4, reflection coefficient S22. So this is representing trace 1 and 2. So depending on the requirement, I can able to modify the representation of the signal in any mode. Okay, so either I can set the traces of S22 and S11, or I can also vary these traces . Let's say I'm selecting S11 and trace as a trace 1, and S21 and trace 2. Now we can apply some marker, either the delta marker, or so I'm selecting the marker type M1. Also I can add more marker like M2 and M3 are added. I have removed the delta marker intentionally, I do not want to use. So M3 value is rated 6.686668 GHz, and in that frequency the corresponding value of the S11 and the S21 will be shown. So you can see here the value of S11, which is the reflection coefficients, is higher than 15 dB, minus 17.75, minus 15.55, minus 15.12 in three different frequencies, as well as the corresponding S21 value is minus 0.01, minus 0.08, 0.02. So this trace, yellow set trace, if you see clearly, this is showing the straight line, and as a DUT right now I have connected a through connection. So through connection is having a property to give you zero transmission coefficient. So the transmission coefficient is almost equal to 0 dB, and it is giving a proper matching. So the S11 is greater than minus 15 dB. So still I believe that we need some more calibration setup, or we have to perform more calibrations so that we can able to move if any error we have made during the calibration. But for the saving the time, I will go measurement of the selected DUT on this setup only, right? So this VNA is having a capability that it cannot able to show the phase value, but since it is a VNA, it will store the all scattering parameters in complex form. Either you can select the dB and phase, or you can select the real and imaginary. So this can be done by the measurement of oscillations by using the key format or span, and here you can see the dB magnitude, the corresponding phase value is rotated by this, so it is measuring the phase also, and suddenly all the values of the S1 parameter is giving you the phase value. That means this confirms this is a VNA which can able to do the complex scattering parameter measurement, but at one time it will show you only the single representation or single value, either the dB magnitude, either the phase value, or any other format. If you go, we can also find out the reticle length of the through connection or delay time required to find out the through connection, since we are connecting a through port connection. You can see here the SWR and the Smith chart is not active right now, since SWR is a property of the one port component, and similarly or the of one port only, and similarly the impedance is the chart which is connected with the connected with the impedance value. So that we will see when we will measure the one port component. Right now I am going to attach a two port component, and believe me that this component we have intentionally made, since we do not have any variable attenuator at microwave frequency in coaxial range. So we have using the waveguide variable attenuator, using the adapter to work as a variable attenuator at frequency. Right now we were connecting a two port fixed attenuator. So this is the attenuator which we have introduced earlier, and I hope you are able to recall that this is a male type N connector and this is the female type connector. And when you see on the port of the VNA, both port of the VNA cable are ending with a type N male connector. So on one side of a type N male connector, this female type N connector will be connected, but on the other side we will be facing problem, since it is a male connector and it cannot be directly connected with the male connector of VNA port. So we are going to use an adapter. Right now I do not have the female to female adapter, but I will arrange, I will making the combination of these two adapter to make a female to female end. So this kind of a connector is known as a 7mm connector, and this side is a type N female connector. So you can see here that we can able to use this connection to make a female to female type N adapter. So for that you have to just take out little bit cover back, and this cover will be easily come over on the cover left by the previous connector. So now you can see this is making the end to end connection for the type N connector. This will be easily go here, and always keep in mind that when you are connecting the male to female connector, always rotate the male connector part, do not try to rotate the female part, female with this type N male connector of the attenuator. Now please connect this attenuator between the port of the VNA. So if you recall earlier, the S21 value was about 0.0 something, 0.8 or 0.4 something. Now after connecting a 10 dB of attenuation, it is showing me the S21 value about minus 10.23, minus 10.17, minus 9.51, almost equal to the 10 dB. But you can see there is a good matching when you talk about the value of S11, minus 19, minus 23.58. So they are representing very good matching, and we can able to change this value also. Okay, so the marker 3 is selected as a changing marker, and you can see continuous change in the value of marker frequency with respect to their corresponding value of S11 and S21. So you can see there, it is very easy to measure the scattering parameter of any two port component using the VNA, and that's why it is having the cost like that per gigahertz, 1 lakh rupees per gigahertz. So this will give you all measurement facility within a few fraction of a minute if you have performed very good calibration. And you recall that we discussed the verification standard also. So after the calibration, one can use or connect the verification standard to verify whether the calibration is performed well or incorrect. So this is having some additional feature like storing the data in USB port. You can easily access the USB port. Also you can apply some external modulating signal by using this BNC cable. So this data can be stored, and for storing of the data. This save button can be used, and once I press the save button, it is asking me to save here, so I can save this measurement data in any of by giving some name. So you can see, you already seen that we have done previous measurement, and based on the component which we have measured, like copper antenna we have measured, flower type antenna we have measured, there is some inductive antenna is measured. So we have stored, we have measured many number of component, but I am not storing this data, but just giving you the idea that the nowadays any measurement system is having a capability to store the data in a CSV or Excel form, and then we can import the data using the USB on our PC and modify the graph as per our good or best representation. So now we are connecting a two port component, which is a variable two port component. Please connect the two port variable attenuator. So you can see here that a waveguide attenuator with the help of two waveguide adapters has been connected between the two port of the VNA, and we can see what is the change we are seeing. We can able to see on the S21. So in S21 you can see the value of transmission coefficient has been reduced less than minus 80 dB. Since the minus 80 dB is available here, it is reduced by minus 80 dB. That means it is attenuating the signal by 80 dB or more than 80 dB. Must be the 90 degree. So must be the minus 90 dB. And this frequency span is from, this frequency span of 7.2 GHz may be starting from the 800 MHz to the 8 GHz. So in this frequency, the attenuation level we can read here also, minus 91, minus 9, minus 86 in 3.5, 36 GHz. Other frequency we are having little bit change value. So you may have asked question, sir, why the second data or the second digit of this number are keep changing? Since this is a economical VNA, we cannot rely on the exact measurement of this VNA until unless we will store. So there will be the small fluctuations because of the capability of this VNA, and that's why it is termed as the accuracy parameter of the VNA. So we can say the accuracy of this VNA, since it is a economical VNA, is little bit poorer than very standard VNA. Those kind of a standard VNA you will find in the high end laboratory like DRDO laboratory or the ISRO laboratory or any other organization's laboratory, difficult in academics. And other parameter of S11, which is shown by this yellow color, is that signal is totally being is almost equal to 0 dB. One is here, minus 19 is here, so this must be near about 0 dB. So from here to here, the value of relation coefficient is 0 dB. That means signal is not able to propagate inside this waveguide attenuator. Why? What should be the reason? Since I have told you that this VNA can able to measure parameter up to 8 GHz, and we have connected a component which is working after 8.2 GHz. Since this is a X band attenuator, so the frequency is not able to propagate inside this attenuator, since it is working in a higher frequency band than the capability of this VNA. So just for the demo purpose we are using, since we do not have any variable attenuator which are working in the frequency range less than 8 GHz. Can you change some step by this knob? Yeah. Okay. Make some more changes. So while there is some changes in the value of attenuation, you can see there is a little bit fluctuation in the value of S21. S11 remains almost constant. So this is representation of the variable attenuator, that we can change any other value of the attenuation, 10 dB, 20 dB, 30 dB, 40 dB, but you cannot find the significant change over here. As I told you, the connected attenuator is working after 8.2 GHz, whereas our VNA is able to measure only the 8 GHz. So now we are connecting a one port component, so we can able to measure the S11. So this is the 2x2 antenna array, and a single point is made here to feed the all antenna together at the same time. Okay, and there's a special design for feeding these four antennas simultaneously that you will read in the next semester. And at the center point, you can see on the back side how the coaxial connector is connected. So this coaxial connector of the VNA port is connected with the input port of this antenna array, and the cable is connected to port number 1. So we can see the S11 parameter of this network, this antenna. Right now I have selected a trace as to represent the two value, or better I will see only the one value of S11. So the two traces are coming. This S11 is representing the value of Christian coefficient for this antenna array. And if I rotate this marker, the minimum value is occurring something at 2.24 gigahertz. So please avoid this white trace. It is representing for S21, and we are focusing on this M3 and the value of S11 only, which is shown here over here. And I can reduce the span to find out proper range. Oh yes, this is the frequency, and start frequency, since I am expecting this negative peak of the antenna, which is representing the resulting frequency of this antenna, about 2.24 gigahertz. So I am setting a frequency keeping the 2.24 gigahertz as center frequency. So assuming, let's say, 1 gigahertz for lower frequency, 1 gigahertz positive, upper frequency. So let's say I am selecting the start frequency as 1.25. Okay, I just did a mistake. Back 1.25. You can see this value is appearing over here. So minimum frequency I selected as 1.25 gigahertz. Start frequency. Stop frequency I'm selecting, since I'm reducing the resolution bandwidth, 25 gigahertz. So this span is now made from start from 1.25 gigahertz to the stop frequency 3.25 gigahertz. Expected value of S11, which is resonating frequency, is near about 2.24 gigahertz. So this antenna is radiating not at 2.25 gigahertz. So I can use this knob to check. Okay, marker M3. So this marker 3 is representing the negative peak on this yellow line, and this is the 1.908 - 22.3 dB. So this is the value of resonating frequency for this antenna. And since this is antenna and it has the radiation on this direction, so you can see as I am changing the position, there is a change in the value of S11, since the maximum radiation is done from this direction on the top of the antenna. So you can modify this value also. So since antenna S11 depends on the surface on which it is radiating, if I change the position of the S11, change the position of the antenna, the value of S11 will keep changing. So this is the only representation how we can able to measure the S11. And on the measurement for a Gibson coefficient S11, I can select the various format. It is representing the value in dB magnitude. Just focus on this value dB. If I select the phase, so it is representing the reflection phase. Since this is a one port, it can also show me the as the lower value, and you can see this is the minimum as the lower value, 1.9 gigahertz is the resonating frequency. So here the antenna is properly matched, 1.67, less than 2 value of is the lower, whereas for the other frequency 2.24 gigahertz, the value of reservoir is infinite. You can see the location of the marker 1. So line, yellow line is going on the topward direction up to the maximum level, and then if you look for the 2.6 2.8 gigahertz frequency, this is again the high VSWR. If I select the Smith chart represents the value of complex impedance. So Smith chart, as we have already seen and studied, it is representing the complex impedance, and so VNE is able to give you the input impedance, complex input impedance directly, only by selecting few keys. There are some other parameters which you can able to find out, and right now we are not focusing on that, but the important thing is that VNE is a very versatile instrument which can able to characterize any component, 2 port, 3 port, 4 port, 1 port component, for a number of parameters, whether it is involved with the diffusion coefficient or return diffusion parameter or transmission parameters. So I hope this will be very helpful for you to have the better understanding of this system. So the VNA which we are having is able to perform the role of three instruments, as you can see: antenna and cable test, network analyzer, meter, voltmeter. So right now we have selected the mode as a network analyzer, so that right now VNA is working to measure the scattering parameter in micro frequency range. Okay.